In this video, we'll show you how to design and style an engaging email. To start with a brand new email, click Create. After that, enter a name and click Create Email. You can start from scratch, or you could use a template to speed up your process. If you choose Basic Layout or Fully Designed, you'll go to our template library. Let's go with Fully Designed. Just so you know, some template options vary by plan, so check out our pricing page for details. To narrow your search, use the dropdowns to filter by email purpose, style, and industry. Of course, you can also use your saved templates or recently sent emails as a base. The example we'll work with has a simpler design. So click Basic Layouts, find the one called Minimal, and click Apply. You can change a template at any time. Just click the dropdown by Save and Exit, and choose Change Template. Before moving forward, let's choose an audience. This is a requirement for functions like dynamic content. So click Save and Exit to get to the email checklist. Then in the To section, add or edit the recipients. Make sure you check Personalize the Send To field and save. When you're ready to get back to the template, highlight the preview of the design and click Edit Design. Or you could click Edit Design in the Content section. And we're back. Let's move on to content blocks. These are buttons, images, products, and more. Before you add a content block, it can help to check out layouts. These create columned areas so you can visualize the placement of your design elements. Pre-built layouts already have content blocks chosen to get you started. Now, let's head back to the Content tab, and we'll cover a few different content blocks, starting with Image. Go ahead and drag and drop the Image block into the design. Then, click Add Image to select an image. You can either upload an image, browse the ones you have in Content Studio, or find an image from connected apps. One thing to note here is our Canva integration. With this connected, you're able to pull images directly from your Canva account, and the edits you make in Canva will be reflected in Mailchimp. After you find an image you like, click Insert to add it to the template. Up next, let's check out visibility. Here's where you turn on dynamic content. This helps you personalize parts of your email with unique content for certain recipients. In other words, we'll show and hide a content block based on the conditions you set. So choose an audience and click Continue. Then click Customize Recipients, and you're ready to set your conditions. This example is from The Potted Planter, which is a fictional flower shop. We'll say tag is Farmer's Market. That means anyone labeled Farmer's Market will get this image. You can have up to 5 overlapping rules for each piece of content. Okay, when you're done setting your condition, close the drop-down panel and click Save. Now, follow the same steps to add another image. Keeping with our potted planter example, our condition for this image will be tag is experienced planter. All right, let's take a peek at how dynamic content looks in action. Click Preview, then switch on Enable Live Merge Tag Info. To test out different contacts, you can enter an email address in the search or use the arrows to browse alphabetically through your contacts. As you'll notice, the image changes depending on a contact's tag. For the potted planter, the image of a gardener appears for anyone tagged experienced planter. And a plant shows for people tagged with farmer's market. See, this is what we mean by personalization. The next content block we'll touch on is product recommendation. You can use this to create a personalized product feed for your customers. But you'll need to have a store that's connected to Mailchimp. To add this block, drag and drop Product Rec. Next, use the dropdowns to choose a store and select a product feed. If you'd like to make a new feed, click the Select a Product Feed dropdown and choose Create a New Feed. Moving on, you'll set your recommendation type, like products a customer has recently viewed. Pick a fallback recommendation in case your store doesn't have enough customer data. And to personalize your feed even more, add a filter. As an example, maybe you only want to show products from a certain collection. After you're done with your settings, name your feed and click Save. There's one more step to go, so click Next, and you can adjust your feed's layout and background color in the Content tab, and change the styles for your text in the Design tab. Once you're done, just click outside of the editing panel. Good work so far. Let's move on to Styles. In the Styles tab, you can set the universal feel of your email. For example, you could set the background color for the entire email. But you can also set styles by sections. We have header, body, and footer. If you click the name of a section like header, the background color you set will only apply to that area. You can also set the style for a single content block. Let's say you only want to change the font for the headline. You'd click the headline and then use the dropdowns to adjust the type of font, the font size, and so on. As you know, headlines need to be attention-grabbing. But it can be a challenge to come up with fresh ideas or make edits on the spot. To help speed along your creativity, try quick actions from Intuit Assist to change the tone or shorten the text. Or if you need something more specific, just click Custom and enter a prompt. Whenever you're good to go, click Done. We've been editing in the desktop view. But you can switch between desktop and mobile at any time. To access the mobile view, click on the smartphone icon. Then click in the content block you want to edit, like the call to action button, and scroll to the device-specific section. For a style to apply to mobile only, you'll need to turn off Link Desktop and Mobile Styles. Now, click the arrow for On Mobile and set your styles. Let's say we want the button to be a little bigger on mobile. For size, let's click Medium. Not bad, but this would look better if the padding was even all around. So check Apply to All Sides. And yeah, that's better. We're good with mobile editing for now. We'll click the desktop icon to return to our original view. This design is coming along nicely, but you might need to move some elements around. Just click on a content block in the design, then click and hold the Move Block icon, and finally, drag and drop the block. If the new placement doesn't work for you, you could delete it with the Remove Block icon, or simply click the Undo arrow. Just a quick point on comments. You can leave notes directly in the builder to help your team collaborate on the design. Before you finalize a design, it always helps to preview and test it. So let's click Preview to check out Inbox Preview. This shows you how your email will appear in different email clients on various devices. After all, the same email viewed in Gmail on a phone could show up differently in Outlook on a tablet. Having said that, it's still a good idea to send a test email to get your team's feedback. With that, we're just about done with designing this email. To reuse your design, click the arrow by Save and Exit, and choose Save as a Template. Nice work! We'd love to see you keep the momentum going. Try out different templates to build your next email. Maybe even throw in some dynamic content.